Hi, this is Shawn from MopareEcoDiesel.com, and today I have received a box from K&N. I'm going to show you something that just came out, just got released, and if you got an EcoDiesel truck, the Ram EcoDiesel truck, I'm going to show you what a really cool upgrade is. As all of you guys know, the filter, the cabin air filter for our trucks is about $30, and this filter was $39. So this is what I have. All right, so this is the box that it arrived in. And here it is. So this is a K&N lifetime washable cabin air filter. This carries the same principle as your K&N filter you'd normally put into your air intake. And the difference is this is not red with that same oil. I don't know what they use for the oil, but this is going to be high flow, and I'll tell you why this was important for me. Alright, so this is your air filter. It's in the same type of packaging that the one for your engine comes with, but as you can see, it's not red. I don't know if it's going to be a marketing gimmick if they are going to want you to use the different special oil, which they show here. I don't know if it's just undyed or maybe scented, or I haven't experienced that yet. Let me sniff it. Doesn't have any kind of odors. Kind of smells kind of fresh. So this is for our trucks. Now, I'll tell you what the problem was. So I ordered the original kit off of Gino's Garage, which is a good kit. It's not bad. But the filter I installed at 20,000 miles, and I promise you this, right at 40,000 miles, I started getting a squeak, a really loud squeak with my air conditioner blower, my blower motor inside the truck. And I was like, oh my gosh, it went out already at 40,000 miles. Shoot. And if I turned the fan on really high, the squeak would go away, but at low speeds, it would start squeaking again. So I'm like, dang it, I put an air filter in there to help protect it. So I, you know, pulled off into Evanston, removed the plate, pulled the filter out, and it was covered in dirt, and it was clogged up. So I went into Walmart. They didn't have this filter. They didn't have the right sizes. All the stores were closed. And when I got online at AutoZone, it was $35 for this air filter. And I was like, nah, screw that. I'm not going to do that. And I heard that K&N was releasing these for certain vehicles. And, I mean, that's pretty cool. I'm a lifetime guy. I like to have something where I can clean it and not throw something away. So I'm really environmentally conscious. So, you know, $35 is a lot of money for me to be spending on a cabin air filter. And I suffer from severe allergies, and the diesel smoke and the soot and the dirt roads that I drive on all night is really compounds a big problem. So finding this was really hard, because if you get online anywhere, you look up any 04 to 2014 Ram truck, and we do have the provision for this, but it always says NA. For cabin air filters for our trucks. It doesn't matter if it's a 1500 to a 4500. Every single year, no matter what parts catalog you look at, says NA, not available, or not applicable. So what I did was I did a back search on the part number for the air filter, the Wix air filter that I had. Fram actually had the best back search engine And there's a ton of applications that use the exact same filter. And basically, this is out of a Dodge Avenger. Dodge Avenger uses the same air filter for our truck. Same dimensions, same part number, same everything. So look it up for a Dodge Avenger. But I'll give you a sneak, an easier quick pick. Part number, VF2013. So you can say that it was very recently made. 8/15/2014. Today is 8/20. So 5 days ago. So this was just barely made. This is brand new. I mean, that's how new it is. 5 days old. So there you go. 5 days old. So yeah, here's the instructions. I'll just wrap this up. This is so stupid easy. Yeah, so you can see this is a Dodge Avenger. So it has the same glove box design that we do. So you drop the glove box down. There's a little cord right here that you pull forward and it pops up. Now that's a pain in the butt. The rest is easy. Then you squeeze in on these two and the door will drop down further. Okay, see, the door will drop all the way down. You can even remove it, but you don't need to. And then inside, you'll see your cutout of your cabin air filter that you installed. You can either buy that on eBay or Gino's Garage, which they're back ordered as of this date because the Ram 1500 owners are really consuming a lot of those. And then, of course, you just pull it out and then slide in your new one. Now, over here in the corner, what you don't see on the trucks is there's a panel that comes over and it kind of blocks this, so it's not as clean and easy as this install. You kind of got to force it and wiggle it and try to jimmy it in there, but it'll go in there. So I think this is an awesome upgrade. You know, for $5 more, literally $5 more to get a better filter that's cleanable and lifetime and a high quality filter, I think it's worth it. Now, this is what also is worth it. So my filter was being restricted. You can hear when you slide in the Wix filter or the Fram filter, when you slide that in, the fan will actually start blowing a lot less air. There is a restriction with the paper air filter. Now, it is completely evident. If anybody has seen the demonstration there in the stores at AutoZone or Napa with the K&N air filter, that is exactly what happens on your truck. And if you turn your blower motor on with your hand, if you turn the blower motor on and you put your hand there, with your other hand, you slide this in at the same time, you will feel less air going through that vent. So, you know, with 20,000 miles, I drive a lot of miles. I drive a lot of dirty miles, so it's more of a problem for me. So this is going to save me a lot of money, and it's not going to impede my performance of my fan. The squeaking noise, I've had this off for about 3,000 miles, and I have not had that squeak come back at one time. So if it went right away, it was the filter. And so I need a high flow. But damn, at $30 a piece, $35 if you go to AutoZone, that's a lot of money for this stupid little air filter. I mean, our high efficiency, high trap rate filter from Mopar isn't even $30 for the outside air filter. And it's way bigger than this. That's ridiculous. So get on there, buy the VF2013 panel air filter from K&N for your Ram truck, and install it. This, I guarantee you, will be the last panel air filter that you buy. I mean, look at that. That's, you can definitely see that it's a high flow. You know, this isn't for an engine, but there you go. My goal on this website is to save people money. Make their truck work even better than what you can find out there, and help people make the right decision and hopefully make an educated decision. So thank you for my sponsors, for Ram EcoDiesel, for my website. The Ram EcoDiesel community is growing and getting very large. So you can follow me on MopareEcoDiesel.com and visit my website at MopareEcoDiesel.com. If you have a question, I have a chat board on the back of the website. You can submit a request or a question, and maybe a community member or I can help you with it or research it and figure it out for you. So thank you very much. Have a good day. Bye.